Okey, kalau kau tanya pendapat aku berkenaan dengan penyebaran audio daripada orang SPRM tu sendiri ataupun dengan lebih tepatnya Latifah Koya terhadap orang-orang dekat media, pada aku benda tu sangat salah dan sangat tak beretika. Kenapa dia salah? Sebab dalam badan SPRM tu sendiri terdapat struktur pendakwaan. So maknanya sebarang kes-kes pendakwaan yang berlandaskan kepada tuduhan-tuduhan daripada rasuah dan sebagainya ada terdapat dia punya timbalan pendakwa raya yang tersendiri. Jadi apa timbalan pendakwa raya dia buat, akan bawa kes ni ke mahkamah, akan bacakan pertuduhan, dan sekiranya tertuduh tidak mengaku bersalah, akan wujudnya perbicaraan di mahkamah. So the whole process will be based on the law. It will be a trial by the law. But what happened when there was a leakage of that audio by the body itself in the presence of everyone in the media? This to me is very disrespectful. This is a slap and this is a sheer insult to the rule of law. Because as much as we want to uphold the sanctity of the law, but what we saw in that incident is a trial by media. Apabila perspektif orang cuba dikorek berlandaskan atau dengan cara kita menunjukkan audio tersebut, orang ramai akan memberi reaksi sama ada positif ataupun negatif berlandaskan kepada emosi semata-mata. Sedangkan the state of guilt, the state of innocence are only to be determined by law, having seen all the law, all the evidence by way of documents or the testimony of the witnesses who come to court and tell their part of the story. Jadi apabila kita membuat statement-statement macam ni, kita secara tak langsung, kita tidak mengendahkan suatu prinsip undang-undang, iaitu seseorang itu tidak bersalah. Tak kisahlah macam mana kau ingat dia bersalah, selagi mahkamah tak menentukan yang dia itu bersalah. A person remains innocent until the court determines otherwise. So when this happened, when emotion is building up based on what we only hear without actually looking at the authenticity of the proof, we are actually taking the mantle, the role of the judge, and we are doing the work of the judge, and that is not what the justice system asks of us, a country with the sovereignty of the law. Bila orang kata pasal rakyat hakim negara, mula-mula benda ni tercetus masa zaman pemerintahan kerajaan terdahulu yang mana dah jadi pembangkang dah pun, it does sound very appealing to the ear of the public, but as a lawyer I think it's wrong, it's ridiculous, it is disgusting that one assumes the role of the judge and thinks that whatever that is heard is enough for him to form his opinion of the state of innocence or guilt of a person. Because we disregard the importance of having the significance of the institution of justice, i.e. the court, by way of proper adjudication only conducted by the judge and not us. Rakyat hakim negara, tak betul. Rakyat bukan hakim negara. Rakyat tu penentu siapa ahli-ahli politik kau. Tetapi yang menentukan sama ada betul ataupun tak sesuatu undang-undang itu bukan kerja kau. Sama ada menentukan orang tu salah ataupun betul dari segi perundangan, itu bukan kerja kau. Itu bukan kerja aku. Kerja aku ni nak beritahu kau yang apa kau cakap tu salah.